Most people that have guns don't use them on other people. You said if you had a gun, you're going to use it.
Well,
you don't.
What's that I'm saying? If you have a gun, you better be able to use it?
Yes. Most people are overwhelmingly good.
Okay, yeah, well, but most people have a gun. 350 million Americans, there are 310 million guns.
Right, that doesn't mean that most people have a gun. It doesn't distribute exactly that
but,
way.
But, you know, people are blaming violence in movies and videos.
Well, that's
on
insane.
This.
That's insane.
No, really?
It's not.
What is it called? Art of War, Man of War? What do the kids play?
Call of Duty.
We don't allow that in our house. Really? So busy buying Call of Duty. Needs to be more hugs in households.
Those aren't mutually exclusive.
Well,
nothing in Call of Duty says you can't hug your family.
Well, you know what?
This boy's
favorite game pen was Call of Duty.
Yes, and many peaceful people. You're doing the same thing. Call of Duty is the most popular game there is. Everyone's playing it, so of course bad people are going to play it too.
Yeah.
To try to blame Shakespeare and the violence in Shakespeare and the violence in art for violence that happens in the real world is something that's been tried for years and is always wrong. People must take responsibility. We must stop blaming society and actually blame the perpetrator.
Yeah, you know what?
Call of Duty is something that young people like and enjoy, and it's a game.
I think
and
that's
most
the
of those
parents,
people
though,
are inv- most of those people
kids.
Are violent. Most of the
just
people
see,
are
like,
violent.
We need to take responsibility for our own houses.
And we have to stop disliking our children. We attack comic books. We attack monster movies. Now we're attacking video games. Love our children and know that they
can
play.
Take care of your household.
Let them play.
Jamie Foxx is one of the only celebrities that
tweeted out. Jamie Foxx is wrong.
Well, he says cannot turn our backs and say that violence in films or anything that we do doesn't have some sort of influence. It does. I go along with that.
Blame the killers. Why not blame the killers?
Well, some of the killers learn their killing through movies.
Blame the killers, not the artist.
Right.
Why are you blaming artists for something that bad people did?
And
Shakespeare is not a bad person. He wrote beautiful stuff. It has suicide, it has murder, and it tells us something about our hearts. And people who watch Shakespeare don't kill, and Call of Duty is art. It is not some sort of propaganda thing.
Well,
and that's an easy way out.
How about this? This is a case of violence with guns, video games, and mental health. Now, here's a kid who was borderline autistic with Asperger's. They have a lot of social problems.
They don't know how to. No violent problems.
No. Autistic kids are usually victims. My point is that if you sit this kid in a room all day shooting people, if they have no social skills.
How do you know that?
Because it's been.
Well, he had no social skills.
There's no evidence that Asperger's syndrome people go violent from playing games. You have not one data point of evidence on that.
I'm not saying that.
Well, you just said it.
Well, let me try to be clearer.
Please.
Here's a person who has troubles figuring out what's social and what's not. And he's inundated with shoot. And then
right.
A little plan comes across, well, maybe I'll just go to school and shoot people.
No, you've just done cause and effect where it doesn't exist.
There's no guilt. There's no conscience.
No, that's not true that there's no guilt and no conscience.
He wouldn't make eye contact with
his barber. Please don't tear those people apart. I have good friends with
Asperger's.
They have conscience. They have empathy. All of that is not true. You're spreading lies about people who are part of our society and that we need to love and take care of and cherish.
It's not the media. It is not violent movies. It is the politicians. And I call on the politicians to do something once and for all.
Politicians won't do anything until the people speak up, and that means all of us. They are afraid not to be reelected. They're afraid that the people who support gun control will not vote for them, and they won't get in. So you have to let them know that we are not for assault guns for the average person.
Please let us not attack people with Asperger's syndrome.
No, that's not. But I will say this, okay? The media is still in the town of Newtown, and there are signs all over the place saying it's time for you to leave. I think that the media needs to go home and leave them alone.
Stop scaring her.
What do you say? It's the CNN newsroom. What do you say?
I speak from personal experience. The media's job is to shine a light on some of the darkest
places
in our world.
But you can do that if there's a parent. Parents can blog. They need to leave these kids alone. So what do you say?
The media is part of the solution.
I would say that the first few days there needed to be heavy coverage.
Yeah.
Because it's a horrific story. But after a week or two, maybe let your Connecticut people hang in there a little bit. But all that national media and the trucks and the horns and the screaming.
Out.
10? You think the media needs to go?
No, I think the media has done terrible, terrible things to us, misunderstanding math. It's an anomaly. It's a horrific thing. But I don't want my children scared by this stuff running 24 hours. And we probably shouldn't be talking about it, all things considered.
Yeah. It was a big story of the week, and that's what we do here on Hot Talk.
You keep underlining story, and it's not a story, it's a tragedy.
It is a very
it's
big
not
tragedy.
A story.
How about it's a tragic story?
A tragic story.
Look, we have to do more than tell stories.
This is what I love about our Hot Talk panel. Thank you all for being here.
Asperger's syndrome people don't become violent. There's no evidence.
For more information on our panelists, go to wendyshow.com.